finally tonight, the man who brought the issue of doctor-assisted suicide squarely into the national spotlight. Dr. Jack Kevorkian died today at a hospital in Michigan. Ray Suarez has our report.
He was an outspoken, retired medical pathologist from Michigan who became known as Dr. Death. Jack Kevorkian said he helped more than 130 terminally ill people die between 1990 and 1998. He used a device of his own invention, a suicide machine, that let the patient press a button, delivering a fatal dose of drugs. In 1990, after his first assisted suicide case, Kevorkian defended his actions on this program, then called the McNeil Lehrer NewsHour.
It's up to a physician with his medical expertise, combined with logic and common sense, and a totally free mind to evaluate whether this person's desire and wish is medically justifiable. And if it is, then I think it's a physician's duty to offer that option to the patient. And I wanted to demonstrate also that there's a great need for it in this country.
Right from the start, though, there was fierce criticism. On that same program, lawyer and medical ethicist Susan Wolf was interviewed by Robert McNeil.
I think it's blatantly unethical. The medical profession has repeatedly rejected suggestions that physician-assisted suicide be legitimated. Doctors are supposed to be healers, not killers. Beyond that, I think it's most probably illegal.
I don't recall.
Michigan authorities agreed and tried repeatedly to prosecute Kevorkian. There were three acquittals and a mistrial, but he was finally convicted in 1999 after he'd allowed 60 Minutes to broadcast the lethal injection of a patient who had Lou Gehrig's disease.
Guilty of lesser charge of second-degree murder.
Kevorkian spent the next 8 years in prison. He was released on parole in 2007, still defiant, but promising not to break the law again.
I will not do it again because it would be counterproductive. What would it serve? What purpose? It's now up to the people to fight for their right, and this is a right. It's a natural right. You're born with that right.
Jack Kevorkian's own life ended early today in Royal Oak, Michigan, where he'd been hospitalized with pneumonia and kidney problems. He was 83 years old.